All right, Jordan, that was for you, buddy. That's a hard song to play on a Sunday over here at WSLV, but man, congrats for even getting to your third day. Springfield, Alabama's Randy Howell is leading with 64 pounds right now. He's in first place, and Jordan's in sixth with 51 pounds, so it should be a shootout today. Keep you posted as the day goes by. But, you know, I'm a big fisherman, but I also love reading a good devotional. You know, I talked about earlier about being a fisherman of man. So what I'd like to say, well, first I'd like to thank my sponsor, my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And in the mornings, it's usually Maxwell House Coffee, but today it's Monster Energy. I'm still drained from the weekend. Kids had ball tournaments, and I'm just pooped out. So I would like to start out reading you a little something. It says, "We are the real," and real is spelled R-E-E-L. It says, "We are therefore Christ ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us." That's in 2 Corinthians 5:20. This is from a guy you may know, and I got up kind of late this morning. No biggie, but usually I like to be here way early to get everything going for you guys, all you listeners out there. And I had set my alarm clock on this duck call. I'm thinking, hey, that'll wake me up. You know, I've had this super alarm for months, and it's been doing the job. But so I set it up on a duck call, thinking, hey, 4:30, I'll be up. But anyways, I had this dream early this morning that I was duck hunting with Uncle Si and Jason Phil from Duck Dynasty. So today I'm happening to read something from the Duck Dynasty devotional that I bought for my wife for Christmas. And this is Jace, and he's saying, "As a kid, I was part of the bass fishing craze. Everyone seemed to have a giant ski boat with a huge outboard motor. We were river rats, and our boat was built for practicality and longevity. We still use it today. I remember asking my dad if we were going to upgrade. He explained to me the difference between fishers and catchers. Despite my dad's belief in his idea of making trends instead of following them, I saved my money and bought myself a fancy ambassador reel. I quickly realized that it's not about the name brand of the tackle or how it looks. It's about who is controlling it. We are all flawed, and some of us look a little rough around the edges, but God uses us anyways. The key is to realize we are the real. Jesus is the Lord, and God is the true." My wife read that to me. We was in bed a couple nights ago, and I was like, wow. You know, that's pretty cool. You know, I've been fishing since I was 5 years old, and first time I was able to fish, I was in, I think it was Brownsville, Texas. Not Brownsville, Bellevue, Texas. So my memory of my first fish was in Texas, me and my dad, and it was a big lake out there in Texas, which I'd love to go back to. And as the years went by, my dad, he took me fishing as well. That was our bonding time. And I'm pretty sure we never had the best. You know, Jace talks about having this ambassador reel, which they are really expensive. Especially in the sport of bass fishing, you put a lot of money into it. And my wife will tell you that. But I remember we didn't have the fancy things. We had cane poles. I think back then they were like $1.25 a piece. But as the years rolled by, we caught fish. And, you know, now I'll be 35 in March, and I tell you what, my goal is to be in the Bassmasters next year. I don't know if it's a pipe dream, but I think if God sees it fit, then I'll be out there on the lake fishing with those guys. But, you know, what he's saying here is it's not about what you have. Like as an unreal, okay? This has a lot to do with, like, I see people coming to church all the time. 7, 8 Bibles. They've got their iPad. It's just, I don't know if they're reading them. I don't know if it's for show. I don't know that. I don't judge that. But what I'm trying to say is, you know, it doesn't matter if you have a $2 Bible. That's what God has given to you. That's what you read the Bible to gain all the knowledge, okay? Just like as in fishing. It may take you years to catch a fish, but after practice, after practice, after practice, you're going to catch them. You're going to know where to catch them. You're going to find you a honey hole. That's what we call them in fishing. You're going to know exactly where to go. Same thing with reading the Bible. I call it the sword. You open that Bible, you start at Genesis. I don't care where you start, really. I don't care if you start Revelations. But you read that Bible, that is in your instructions. Okay, you read it every day. You get equipped with that knowledge. Okay? Once you get that knowledge, you can go out and be a fisherman of man. You can give your testimony. If you're saved, give your testimony, how you got saved. Okay? It's not about all this fancy stuff we've got out here nowadays. You know, I've got $500-$600 invested in fishing equipment. Does it really matter? Probably not. Okay? They've got these fancy depth finders and these echo track systems now. You know, the depth finders are good because they keep you from bottoming, you keep your boat from bottoming out on a rock. You know, we as Christians, we need to have that depth finder. You know, we need to know exactly where that point is. We don't need to lose control. We need to know we've got to better ourselves. Once again, I mentioned we've got to man up, okay? And I just thought this really hit home. It's not at all about what you have, it's how you use it, okay? Knowledge is everything. And I think that's what Jake was trying to get to on this. You know, they grew up kind of poor, which now they have lots and lots of money, but I'm pretty sure that they stuck to their roots. They know where they came from. But this is not about fishing. This is about taking your Bible, reading it every day, go to prayer. I don't care if you pray 3 times a day or 18 times. Get on your knees and thank God for everything you have. Ask for His wisdom and knowledge. Okay, those two together are great. Go out and minister. Go out and talk to people. And that's what I'm getting out of what Jace is saying in this devotional. And I know we have flaws and weaknesses. But we just pray we have the wisdom. We get the wisdom. Okay? I'd like to go to a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, use me despite my flaws and weaknesses. Give me wisdom and insight to recognize my opportunities that you give to me to make you known. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Like I said, that's pretty cool, you know. Remember, we have to put God first before anything else. Before I go fishing, before I do other things during the day, you know, I pray to God, what do you want me to do today? Okay, then I move on after I've talked to God. I talk to my wife. Wife, what do you need me to do today? You know, you put God first, your wife second. I promise you, I can't say that enough. If you do that, your life changes in so many ways. Try it. Give it a day. Give it 2 days. If it works out for you, keep doing it, because I promise you.